So we're just going to take a moment to play a little slideshow for you. And so you just bear with me and just take a moment and we'll get going. And here they are, Ms. Olympia Women's Physique 2013, Dana Linn Bailey, and sidekick Rob Bailey.
Video.
Thanks, man.
That was awesome. I got it all on film. Taped the whole thing. Oh, geez.
Hi.
Hold on. This is what we do. I take pictures of everything. Everyone can get a little wild if you want. Put your hands up. Actually, here, you take it.
What?
This is the beginning. We're taking selfies.
Looks good.
Marketing 101. So, what's up? How is everyone? Good. Good. Hope you guys are alive. You're so quiet. So, we like to have fun here. We like to do our, we do everything together. There's no point of doing this by myself because I wouldn't be here if I was by myself. I would only be here. I'm only here because I have him. From the beginning, this is... Aww, I know. We get all, like, sentimental. We were just in L.A. We were just at L.A., and I had to do a half-hour seminar. And it was, like, question-answer. And people had, like, really good questions. And both of us cried on stage.
I almost
cried.
So
I cried first, and then he almost.
Yeah. I gotta be, like, sort of tough.
Cried.
No.
Yes. So... I don't know. So we do everything together. So, and like any questions, like most of the, like he's the one that got me into training. He's my actual trainer. I work with George Fair for the diet, but I mean, from the beginning, Rob is who taught me how to lift from the beginning and still to this day. So he's good for questions too. And anything with business and
I'm
marketing.
Good on keeping her on track, too, during this whole thing.
Yeah.
She'll ramble forever.
I do. I sort of talk, sort of like how I'm doing right now.
Well, there is a, like a...
There is.
Schedule.
I know.
Don't sit down.
I don't know.
Stand.
I get nervous.
Okay.
Okay.
So...
I like sitting.
Once again, I'll stop her, too, if she gets too wild.
Let's
do your history.
Yes. So, history. No, I always like to start off with like who I am, where I came from, because my background has a lot to do with where I am today. Growing up, I was a six-sport athlete. I started swimming on the swim team at age 5. I was the youngest one. Me and my best friend, we started very, very young, waking up just like the big kids, going to practice every morning. And so I started very early. I also played field hockey, basketball, soccer. I ran track, and I played softball. Is that 6? I know it's 6, so I might have forgot one. But I was always, like every season, I would be playing 2 sports at one time. Especially when you're younger, like I played on a lot of traveling teams. I was on a traveling swim team, which was year round, so we'd mostly be winter and summer, but with the traveling swim team, a traveling soccer team, I played on a traveling basketball team, I was on an indoor track team, and then I also ran track in the spring. So I was basically just going from like, I would go to school all day, and then it would be my scholastic team sport, and then I would be going to a practice at night for whatever traveling team I was on. So. It had a lot to do with discipline, and thankfully my parents kept me on track. But they're who pushed me into doing everything. Like, I maybe wouldn't have just pushed myself, so I do owe that to them. They wanted me involved in as many sports as possible. I was involved in a lot of things during school, academic-wise, too. Believe it or not, I was vice president in middle school. I don't even know what I did, but I was. We had meetings ever so often.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I was on student council. I was one of the... Yeah, remember that picture on the fridge that I look really cute in?
Yeah.
That was my student council picture.
Yeah.
I counseled things. In sixth grade, I don't know what I was counseling. But once I got to high school, that's when I sort of had to narrow my picks down. So I played field hockey in the fall, basketball in the winter, and soccer in the spring. I still swam on the swim team because my job in the summer was lifeguard, so all the lifeguards would swim. And then I was still playing travel soccer. Once college came around, I got recruited to play soccer for Westchester University, where I was a starting defender. We went to NCAA's playoffs, and it's actually where I met this fine young lad. First day of school, he doesn't remember me. He doesn't. I knew what he was wearing to the T. I'm not going to explain.
I don't remember.
Yeah. Well, whatever. I remember you. So a month later, like we became really good friends. And it really wasn't until my soccer career was over that I really got into lifting. And that's sort of when we started dating anyway. It was towards the end of, I think, my last year of soccer.
Last year of soccer.
Last year of soccer. So I had Joy Bailey cheering for me. She was the loudest one.
That's my mom.
She is awesome. Joy Bailey. But yeah, I mean, I have a very small background, like in high school, my gym class, I always picked strength and conditioning, which was the lifting, because in high school, like regular phys ed class was such a joke. So I did strength and conditioning, but it was just upper body day, lower body day, and it was a good basic. And then we lifted a little bit. We would have team lifts in college, but I really did not actually get into lifting until him. So he worked all night as a chef. Believe it or not, he is an amazing cook. I don't know why I can't cook. I learned like the little things that he has taught me on the way. Like I used to hate Brussels sprouts and asparagus, and he taught me how to actually make them good, and now that's all I eat. So you need to teach. We should have teaching class, cooking class. Oh my God, no, really, he's amazing.
Thank you.
Aw, yeah. Give me a compliment. Yes. So he would go to school in the morning when he would actually go, and then, what? It's true. The only class he went to was nutrition, because I was in it and I made him drive me to class. But he would go to school in the morning and then you would prep from, didn't you go in early?
I worked from like noon to midnight.
Basically noon to midnight, but you'd had a 2-hour break in the middle of the day from like 2 to 4 before service started that he would go to the gym. So me being the new girlfriend, I'm like, we never see each other. We never hang out. So he's like, okay, well, from 2 to 4, I'm at the gym. So go to the gym. I'm like, all right. So I started going to the gym. I used to pride myself. I'm like, yeah, I have abs. I eat ramen noodles and McDonald's every day. But like, I was also had practices from soccer every single day and training for games and stuff. So I was always in shape. So I could, I guess, eat like crap. I ate like a poor college student. So I started going to the gym with him and just followed exactly what he did.
I didn't know how to train a girl at the time.
So you see the girl said,
I really didn't even know what I was doing. But yeah, there's like sort of like what we did yesterday.
Like combination movement.
You know, like the curl into like a press, like.
No.
It's like with the lightweights and things. I don't know.
The little pink weights.
I said, I don't know. I think that's what girls are supposed to do, but I'm not sure. So just do what I do. And
so we benched.
It's like, let's bench today. And then she realized that she could get stronger every single week. And before you know it, she was chasing the plates. You know, first she got the 25s on.
Those were the big dogs. When I put the quarters on the sides, I was like, oh yeah, put the big dogs on. I get so pumped. And now it's like hilarious.
And we got to the 35s. I remember the first time you benched 135.
Yeah. It was
I remember
like,
the first time
we
she did a
pull-up. Screaming. And we're like, oh my God. And everyone's just like, what?
Remember when you did, when we started pull-ups and you did like 1 or 2?
Yeah, I used to only do like 2. Yeah.
That was an awesome day.
Now I can, yeah.
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 But yeah, it was a long time in the making. I mean, you're what, 9, 10 years in now?
9, 10 years in, going strong. And I mean, that's 9, 10 years with, I have not taken more than 2 days in a row off. So a lot of like new people that come into this think you're like, I want to see results. Like I want to be on stage and I want to see results fast. It doesn't happen fast. I progressed fast because of my background, like swimming. I sort of already had that wideness of the back. I already had legs from playing soccer. It was just toning and developing and growing in certain areas. So I think a lot of that background of my sports had a lot to do with how I started and where I am today.
So when you started competing?
So when I started competing was about nine months to a year after. So we were at this gym. I always say this story because it's funny. So we're going to this gym and I had no clue about like figure and bodybuilding and all that. I didn't really follow it until a little bit after, like when I started competing. So there's two girls in our gym and they're always carrying their gallons of water around and like packed meals. They always had packed meals and was smelly fish. I'm always walking around like, I'm prepping for a show. I'm prepping. I'm in prep. Oh, I have to do double cardio today because I'm prepping. I'm like, what is this freaking prepping shit? I mean...
I told you she wasn't going
to
be like...
I knew it. I'm trying to watch myself.
So what is this prepping stuff?
Prepping stuff. I was like, so, these girls carrying their gallons of water and they're prepping all the time. So I was like, finally, he already knew. So I was like, what is this prepping thing? So I'm like, oh, they're getting ready for a contest. There was a contest. It's called Lehigh Valley Championships, and it's local to us. So they were prepping for the Lehigh show. So I was like, okay, well, I've been doing this for 8-9 months. I look better than them. I'm going to prep for my show, too. So I started prepping. I was in prep, so I started carrying gallons of water. But no, we got the owner of the gym was an IFBB pro bodybuilder. So in trade for design work, he helped me prep for my first show. I had no clue as far as dieting whatsoever. Like I knew like, oh, eat some protein, and I was living on ramen noodles for God's sakes. So we switched up the diet, started actually eating properly, and it was just a basic diet that definitely got me through. So I owe that to him. And then posing practice, and when I first competed, I don't know if you guys are old enough, but you guys remember when we had to do two suits in figure? The velour full suit, yeah. And oh my God, yeah, and they were all like, the velour textured suit. Yeah, you had a one piece and two piece and they were hideous. Oh. So, bought my ugly suits.
And expensive. We did,
an expensive ugly suit, a velour ugly suit. So I bought my two expensive suits and did the posing and cleaned up my diet. And so I did the first show. And actually those two girls that were prepping so hard didn't do the show. They must have went off their prep. So I continued mine. And
you talk so negative about them.
Oh my God. Well,
one day they're going to see one of these things. And I'm like, oh my God, she's talking about us.
They'll have no idea.
All right.
And we're like, no. So they didn't do the show. I did the show. I got sixth place, and I was too hard, whatever that usually means. Usually, in my opinion, it was because I had abs, and it made my appearance look very hard, and I don't know. That's my only recollection. But looking back, I looked horrible. Like, I was a watery mess. My legs were soft. Upper body was hard. I'm going to explain like sort of the crazy stuff that I used to do that hopefully you guys aren't doing now, hopefully. So I'll tell you what I used to do for diet and the pre-contest diet craziness and now what I do now, which is so much easier. So I competed with figure several times after that. I won a couple shows here and there. I actually did a couple bodybuilding shows and won that, which was weird. But I was still so small. I don't know how I did it. But I would always do really well on the local level. And as soon as I got up to a national level stage, I was just too big, too hard, too whatever. I was almost always two of something. So I can definitely see I shouldn't have placed well. Like looking at them, I just did not fit in. So I would be first on a local level and then dead last as soon as I stepped on a national stage.
We were hard-headed at the time.
Yeah, we're like, no, I look the best.
We're still hard-headed. No, that's not why, but we knew that we had to change your training.
Yeah.
We knew that we had to change your diet. We had to make so many changes, and we just refused to.
Well, the biggest thing for me is you got to... And this goes for everyone. You got to weigh out what do you want out of competing? Do you want to compete because you want to be this professional bodybuilder or figure competitor? Or do you compete because you like to do it and it's a passion? For me, and it's still a passion. I'm somehow doing very well at it, but it's still just a passion. It's something I like to do. It's something that I feel very challenging, and I get a lot out of it. But I didn't want to change my training. Training's what I love to do. It's a stress release. I love every minute in the gym. I feel so much better. I was having a horrible day yesterday in the morning, feeling sick and feeling horrible. I went to the gym and everything's cured after that. There's something about it that I just love, and it shows. If you don't actually like the training part, I don't really know what you're doing then. But you have to weigh it out. So I refused to change my training. I didn't want to just step away from the weights and focus on cardio and just do like really, really high reps. I know like some parts of my workouts now, I do higher reps, but it's still extremely intense.
You just didn't want to scale back
anything. I didn't want to scale back anything. I liked all the muscle. I liked my shoulders. I liked my back. I liked my abs. I didn't want to change my look just to please a panel of judges. Because when it comes down to it, who cares what they think if I don't like myself? I need to like myself first before they can like me. So that's what's more important to me. And luckily, they became the IFBB gods came down and created the physique world, which when I think it was Nationals 2010, was going to be my last show, because it's an expensive sport, and all the national shows, anywhere, if I wanted to keep competing, you had to travel to them, you have to fly to them, it's a buttload of money, and just prepping and getting yourself there. So 2010 Nationals, I was 33rd place out of 35, so I was like, okay, like, I think this is it. I'm sort of wasting my money here. Like, I really like doing this, so I was gonna start doing powerlifting meets and all that kind of stuff. But after that show is when we started hearing buzz about this new division, the physique division. So I was like, what is it? Like, what's going on? What is this new division? And the way that they described it was just, it's a figure girl with a little bit more muscle, a little bit harder, just a little bit bigger and harder. And I was like, wait. Me. That is me. I know that they created a vision for me. So I found out, they finally came out with the first show, which was Junior USA's 2011 in Charleston, South Carolina. We stole
minivan. We were so broke.
So broke.
So broke. And a lot of it was because we were trying to chase dreams in the fitness industry. And as we found out quickly, there's not really much money floating around. So we were trying to do whatever we could to make it work. And yeah, she wanted to do the first women's physique show.
Very first.
We had no budget to fly there. We had no way to even afford gas to get there. Anything. So my brother stole a minivan from work. And he took the work's credit card.
Credit cards we bought gas on.
Paid for gas.
Thank you, Nova.
We didn't eat. We didn't eat.
I had all my
everything
food
was
packed
to pay for her to eat. Yeah. And we just.
They ate
candy.
Candy and Burger King.
Yeah,
and
drove straight through. We actually stopped one night to sleep, and got to the hotel at 3 a.m. and we haggled them down to $40 to just let us shower and take a 3-hour nap. And it was four of us in the hotel room.
No, it was just Jen was there. Yeah.
So I mean, it was a different world. A real different world.
Yeah, and sometimes
we did a lot of weird stuff like that, making it work stuff.
Make it work to chase dreams. So we stole the minivan.
No, slept. My brother stole the minivan. We didn't steal anything.
We didn't steal anything.
In case, you know.
He borrowed the minivan.
Borrowed somewhat.
Borrowed the minivan. Drove down. Got everything ready and prepped. We saved money so we could stay at the host or close to the host hotel.
It was close.
So it was a nicer hotel, and there was actually two beds, so two and two. So I won they had 60 girls show up. It was only supposed to be one class. Physique was only supposed to be one class, no height classes, no nothing. But I think 50 or 60 girls showed up for the first show, so they split it. They're like, okay, we're now going to do two classes, two height classes. So it was 5'4 and under and above 5'4. So I won my class, And I somehow won the overall and became the first pro ever and pro champion in history of IFBB. Boom. my first year in the pro circuit, I did Desert Muscle. So that was 2012. Yeah, 2012. Desert Muscle, I got fourth place. Especially in any new division, the first year is always sort of like up and down. You guys probably, if you were watching it, you're like, I'm so confused. Like, this girl looks like this, and this girl looks like that. Like, all the winners pretty much look different. Sometimes they would look a little more towards figure. Sometimes they were almost more towards bodybuilding. And that's going to happen with pretty much any division this first year. You got to see who comes out, and they got to judge what's at the stage. So I got fourth place in Desert Muscle. They actually told me I was a little bit too big and too hard again. I was like, no, you gotta be kidding me. I just moved up. I thought we were done with this too big, too hard thing. And then there was a couple shows in between there, but then I did